I don't get it. I don't get why people think OneNote sucks. I'm like genuinely confused. You know, one, it's not the worst looking thing on the planet. Like, I get it, you know, it's Microsoft, but aesthetically, not awful. You can see, for example, in this person's situation, they segment things very well. Now I'm a little bit wondering what this bike fix day situation has to do with work and meetings, but you know, maybe it'd be better if their examples made more sense. If you're on a tablet that has the ability to draw and stuff, you can actually do some fun things now. There are a myriad of different ways that you can link things together, ink things, clip and save, organize and share. And I'm gonna get into why OneNote actually might be one of the best note-taking apps on the market, and it's free. I don't hate it. I use my first introduction to productivity apps, so that's bias. But I mean, if we get into OneNote right here, we can see it is a very simple software. But if I show you this example notebook that I have, I like the way that you can add different sections and section groups within a notebook. So for example, if I had a section group, I can put fall 2022 and I can sort of section off my notebook into different parts of my life. So this would be like a school portion. I could take this, get it out of that. And then within it, I can add sections. Then it's, so if I go section, marketing, go 3, quickly change these different section names or colors by marking it what would make sense to me. And then within that, I just like the way that you can segment it. So like lecture notes or 8/24 or 10/24. And if for some reason I wanted to, I could also add another page, put a subsection of lecture notes and within it, sort of nestle it by pressing this, making this a sub page, and then it'll quickly do that. And then you can see how this quickly works. So if, for example, I go here, I had all these different lecture notes within it, very easily was able to take notes, drop PowerPoints in there. Then I had nice sections for like core information for class overview and notes and the class syllabus. Then in here, I did that for other classes as well. And I also segmented different things like homework notes within here as well when I was in school. Funny enough, I used this system for about a month and then I realized Notion was better. So I switched to that, but this is just something that showcases to you how I was using this for a while. So I might have used this for nearly, oh, you know what? I, at the beginning of the semester, put in all of these different things, but you can see how I could easily go here and then I double click on this PDF and it has all the information there, which was good for the time. And I did enjoy using OneNote while I was using it before I found Notion. And I think I like the fact that I can just use it in a simple sense and get advanced with it. One of my favorite features is this dictation option, which is obviously available in other apps, but just it being native within this rather than you needing to use it in a external format and bring it in, I really like that. Drawing functionality on this is pretty nice and basic. So I feel like my cursor abilities are not awful. Okay, I take that back, they're very awful, but you can see that there's a bunch of different pen tips. You can do lasso selects to grab different parts of it. You can change the ink to text. So for example, if I do not cursive, try to write my name, not giving me the option to do ink to text, which is weird, but apparently you can also do math functions within here, which is very simple. And you at any point in this can just go back to writing. And something that I like about OneNote as well is the ability to just drag the notes around and create sections. So I could make both sections next to each other if I really wanted to. So put this right here, and it'd be sort of next to it. It is a little bit clunky from an interface perspective, and it does look a little old, but that's something to point out. But all the core functionality is pretty decent here. So if I go to section and put homework, see that it actually drops down all the different sections that it has and finds different pages that has homework within it. So let's see what's in here. You'll see that it found a page that had current homework. Over here, you can go through all the recent notes that you've looked at. And from a view perspective, you can add multiple different windows. You can switch the color of the background. You can switch the way that you're looking at it like this. Immersive note, which I think is pretty cool. Change the page color to just various shades as well. You could also add grid lines if you really felt like it. This has been core functionality that has translations, the ability to hide authors or show authors. And there's this interesting replay feature, which showcases how it was put together, which is very unique in the sense of figuring out what your note-taking process is actually like upon review. Inserting basic tables and stuff is also an option that I very much enjoy that obviously can be dragged around as shown earlier, like this, as well as files. Audio, you can do an audio recording right here. So for example, right now I'm recording it, it's giving me the file. And if I press stop, the ability to play it, and it also just kind of embeds it on the page as well. You want to take audio notes in that sense. Meeting details, quickly are able to sync with your Microsoft account right here as well. And as shown earlier, you can do different math equations within OneNote too. There's also a native built-in Microsoft Researcher option. So as you can see, the options that they've added to OneNote over the years have been very good, as a lot of these things didn't exist when I used it 3 years ago. And it's for that reason that I recommend, if you want just basic text functionality that has lots of different layers for note-taking for a student, I would say this is a great option if you're on Mac or PC. One of my coworkers uses OneNote, and we use Macs at work. So I know a lot of people like the application. I used it for a little bit. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I just think Notion looks prettier, so that's why I use it. Let me know your thoughts on OneNote, and let me know your thoughts on this video on how to improve your productivity even more.